Good morning. So today, as we have already done, you can see this is my last part of my lesson. So I just gave you a picture of what we have previously learned. It's just to revise because we will be going on listening. Teacher is giving so much of just a part of it. So today I'm going to tell you all the words, overall the lesson in just a bit, a small description. Okay? Before, first.
Whether it is on the land, anything which is living on a particular
Now coming to the orchard, a wonderful avenue. Abba, what the name of orchard? Yes, orchard means it's like a field, like a farm. You'll go to nearby your friends or farmhouses. You heard? It will be a big field which is of plenty of plants and trees which is planted. But do you think different trees? No, yes. Suppose you are planting mango tree. So only the trees of mango will be in a row. If it is a grapes vine, remember grapes, yes. All the grapes will be planted. Means a grape plant will be grown. With the top of this we have branches, a bunch of grapes will be just rolling under. And you can see many plants also like that. Rose plant means a bunch of rose plants will be growing in a rose column center. So they are different places where a particular farmers know they will just grow a paddy together and this wheat together and sugarcane. You can see many sugarcane. So that is what is an orchard. What we call that as an orchard. Now next, diversity of habitats in our state. Now when you see our state is Telangana, there are many people who live on the earth, and there are many birds and animals which live on the earth, and there are many animals or plants which live under the water as well as on the earth. So we have different types of habitats as aquatic habitat and terrestrial habitat in our particular state. Not only in our state children, in entire world there are different types of habitats like aquatic and terrestrial. Plants live only in water? No, plants live either in water as well as outside the water. Means few plants live in water, few plants live outside the water. Right? Few animals live inside the water, few animals live outside the water. Outside the water means floating. No, on the land. Right? Yeah, so human beings live only on the land. Yes, we are terrestrial habitat. What we are? We are terrestrial habitat. But plants and animals are aquatic as well as terrestrial habitat. Understand the difference, children. Plants and animals are aquatic or terrestrial. But human being is the only person who is a terrestrial habitat because we live only on the land. Okay? Next, good habitat and good life. This is very, very important in your life. As I just told you, someone came, just broke your door, so you are not able to live in that particular house because I don't have a door. If someone comes in on suddenly, what I should do? So I don't have a particular house which is not at all good for me. Immediately you'll just exchange and you'll put the door and you'll sit through. Fine, right? So in the way, as I told you, you should not cut trees. You should plant more and more trees so that they are animals and plants as well which is growing on a tree. Whereas, what about my ponds? What about my aquatic? You can see many people, they'll just sweep, they'll take the dust and throw it in the pond. In the villages, it happens a lot. They'll take the buffaloes and they'll wash the clothes and they'll throw all the dust inside the water. But do you at least have a sense of humor that there are few plants and animals living in that particular pond? You are just spoiling the house of that animal or plant. Yes or no? We are spoiling the animal's house as well as the plant. Someone just broke the door or someone is just putting the dust inside our house. We are making such a big noise. But as a human being, we are just throwing the dust inside the pond. How it is possible for an animal or a plant to live in a particular situation? Yes or not? So we should always ensure that we are not spoiling. Instead of spoiling, just don't go near that. That is the best option. Right? So instead of spoiling it, better not to do anything to it. Either we plant a tree or take up pet animals. Ensure your pet animals which you are using or which you are taking care, it should be very good condition. It should be given proper food. Not only food, it should have a proper love also. That is very important for the terrestrial habitats. So in this class we have learned what is the diversity of habitats in our particular state, not only in our state, across the world, and how a good habitat should be. By just not throwing the dust, not spoiling the other's house, but not cutting the trees as well. Okay? This was your lesson. So go through your lesson.